glad you're here. We got a new case while you and Nick were out. Ready to put on the detective hat?
Who's our client?
A fisherman whose family lives on the edge of the Commonwealth. Kenji Nakano.
Nakano? Huh. That name takes me back. My memory's a little fuzzy on the details, though.
Maybe if you bothered writing things down, Nick.
Can't do that. Wouldn't want to put you out of a job.
Huh. I'll remember that the next time you need me to console a hysterical client. Mr. Nakano didn't leave many details. Said he'd go over everything when you meet him. But if you want my guess, missing person case. Guy had a worried look a mile long.
So is the fedora and trench coat mandatory when solving these cases? Because I'm thinking smoking pipe and British accent.
Hey, whatever floats your boat, Gumshoe. The Nakano residence is up in the northeast, near the coast. A small fishing house. He said that he and his wife will be waiting for you.
It's a long walk. That's how the hard cases always start.
Hey.
Do something for you?
Hey, Valentine.
All you gotta do is ask.
Are things okay between you and me?
Honestly, I don't think I could ask for a better partner or a better friend.
Oh, nothing.
Well, all right.
Damn it! Come in! I know you're listening on the other end. Where is she? Where is my daughter?
Kenji, please. You've been at this for hours. Stop. You need sleep.
She's out there, Ray. Someone has her. Raiders, or gunners, or God knows what else.
I hope you don't mind. We let ourselves in.
Nick, thank God. You need to get to work right away. She could be hurt. She could be...
Whoa, slow down. Kenji, was it? Why did you go over the details with me and my partner here?
You have to get to work right away, Detective.
So, what's the story with you and Nick?
Nick didn't tell you? Ran with him on one of his cases a few years back, searching for some sort of lost heirloom. He needed a boat. Things didn't end well. We were double-crossed by the client once we had what he was looking for. I still have some lead lodged into my hip.
Right. Yeah, it's starting to come back to me. Sorry things ended sour.
We got out. That's all that mattered. And now you can return the favor by finding my daughter.
We're here to help. Tell us what happened.
It's all thanks to this damn radio.
Our daughter Kasumi likes to fix things. The radio was her latest project.
Until she made contact with some kidnapper who lured her away from us.
Or maybe she left on her own. She's not a child anymore. Our daughter is 19. She knows how to survive and she's capable. I think maybe she left because she wanted her own life.
No. She would have told us where she was going. She would have said something. I know my daughter is in danger. I can feel it. Find her, please.
Do you have any idea where she could have gone?
We know she took one of the boats, but that's all. She could be anywhere.
We'll find her. Don't you worry.
Thank you. Her room is upstairs, if that helps. And if you had any more questions about her, just ask.
Don't worry, Kenji. We'll get to the bottom of this. Just sit tight.
Mr. Nakano.
Did you have questions? About my daughter.
Why did your daughter really leave? Your wife said she left on her own, but you said it was kidnappers?
I know it was kidnappers. Kasumi is a smart girl, but she doesn't know how horrible people can be. Not like me and Rei. Why would she just leave her family with no explanation? Someone tricked her, got her to leave the safety of home. Every minute we aren't looking for my daughter, her life is in jeopardy.
Tell me more about this radio she was fixing.
I've tried to get that damn thing to work over and over again, but there's nothing. I thought she just wanted to strip it for parts or build a toaster out of it or something, like she usually does. Someone made contact with her, and then they took her. God, what kind of twisted psychopath has my daughter?
Anything more you could tell me about Kasumi? The smallest detail could be important.
I don't know what more to say. She's my little girl, and she doesn't know how dangerous this world is. I never should have let her grandfather teach her how to fix these machines.
Her grandfather? He taught her how to fix the radio?
Ever since she was old enough to walk, yes. Her grandfather had an ear for machines. Kasumi picked up the knack. He passed away recently. He used to scavenge the ruins in the south for parts. I kept telling him he was getting too old.
No more questions right now.
Work quickly, Detective.
Mrs. Nakano.
I suppose you have questions about my daughter.
You and your husband don't seem to agree about why your daughter left.
We both want to find her. The world out there isn't a place where you want to be alone. But Kenji still sees her swaddled in diapers. He doesn't see a young woman with her own decisions to make. Maybe because it's more frightening. She wasn't tricked into leaving without telling us. That was her choice. She didn't want us to follow. Why?
Tell me about this radio your daughter was working on.
I remember Kasumi was very excited about it. I figured she was secretly trying to make contact with Diamond City or another settlement. We're pretty isolated out here. She only has us for company, and Kenji can be overprotective.
I'd like to know more about Kasumi. I'd shine a light on where she's gone.
My daughter is strong, focused, careful. That's how I know she's still alive. But why would she leave without telling us? Maybe we... No, never mind. I don't want to waste your time.
Every detail is important, Mrs. Nakano. Don't hold back.
No, it's nothing. I don't want to distract you, Detective.
Nothing else right now.
Project log. Kitchen mixer. The circuits are still good, but all the mechanical parts are rusted through. Maybe I can...
All right, everyone. I'll be back in a few days. Was there anything else we needed from the city?
Wait, you're going now? No! Wait, Dad, I could come with you.
It is better if I go alone, Kasumi. Do not worry. I have your list.
You don't know what half that list is, Dad. I can help you. Really, I'll be...
I said no. I'm sorry. You're safe here, okay? Just stay put for me.
Okay.
I know you're disappointed, but I won't be long. I love you.
I love you too, Dad. Project log. Lamp. Yep, it's a lamp. Filament plus power equals light. I swear, sometimes I think my parents break these things just to keep me busy.
Thank you.
This is Kasumi's room. Let's see if she left any clues about where she went.
Project log, dreams. Recording what I can remember when I wake up. I keep having the same one. I'm in a white room. People are talking about me like I'm not there, or maybe they just don't care. And then there's this, I don't know, jolt, like a spark of electricity to the back of my head, and then everyone turns to look at me. God, I hope I don't have it again tonight. Project log? Radio. Correction, working radio. I'll finally get some news outside this house. My handle is going to be, let's go with Ohm's Law. That should confuse the creeps. And if someone actually gets the reference, then we'll at least have circuitry in common. Project log? Myself. I never really thought about who or what I am, but God, where do I start? The radio. I was right about the range. I managed to get a signal, a strong signal, from up north. There's a group of people up there. They say they're all synths. Synthetic people. Made by the Institute. They are trying to build a place for their kind, where they can be themselves and be accepted for what they are alongside human beings. It sounds wonderful, but then they started asking about me, and some questions came up. Questions I don't have answers to. I mean, I've always felt off, like I'm not really supposed to be here, but then there are things in my childhood I can't remember, and I've been having strange dreams. I'm going to go to meet these synths. I have to know the truth about myself. They've told me to sail up north to a town called Far Harbour. I can make my way to them from there.
So the daughter takes off by boat, but more importantly, the There's a colony of synths up near this Far Harbour. We need a way to get there. Let's go talk to Kenji. He knows the waters better than anyone.
Have you finished your investigation? Did you find anything?
I need to ask you an important question. Are you sure your daughter's human?
What kind of question is that? Why are you asking?
I think I know where Kasumi went. A place called Far Harbour.
She went that far up north? God, that explains why she took the boat. There's no time to waste. You have to go after her.
Wait, did you find out why she left, Detective? Who she was speaking to?
What does it matter?
Because I know my daughter, and if she didn't tell us where she went, then she had a reason. Don't you want to know if she wants to be found?
You're right, Detective. Did you find any clue to why Kasumi left home?
Your daughter made contact with a group of synths. She thinks she's one of them.
What? That's crazy.
She's not a synth. She's our daughter. We raised her. I gave birth to her. She's flesh and blood, not a synthetic.
Maybe your daughter is just confused, having an identity crisis.
Oh God, does she even think we're still her parents?
This is what I was afraid of. Someone twisting my daughter's mind. You have to get to Far Harbour. Take my ship on the dock. It has a guidance system, a final gift from my father. And it's built for distance.
What can I expect out there, Kenji?
I only made the trip to Far Harbour once, when I was a boy. All I remember is that my father did not want to stay long. Something about the air being bad.
I'll get to the bottom of this, Kenji.
Thank you. I know you haven't asked for a payment, and we can't offer much. But here, please take it. I insist. For expenses, if nothing else.
I know it'll be hard waiting for word, but try to carry on like normal. We'll be back as soon as we can.
Find us, please.
Up, Alan. We got visitors.
Mainlanders ain't nothing but trouble.
Put the damn gun down. Are you lost? This is Far Harbour. We don't get many visitors around here.
We don't need no freeloaders or more help, Mainlander. So you can get back in your boat and leave.
Alan, this isn't your dock. It belongs to the whole town. And that means strangers are welcome. Sorry, you've caught us during a difficult time. But Alan's got a point. Not all visitors have good intentions. So, what's your business here?
A young woman from the Commonwealth named Kasumi may have passed through here. Her family hired me to find her.
Some sort of detective, huh? Well, she came through here all right.
At least we know she made it this far.
Damn it. Mariners ain't coming.
Something's coming through the fog!
You, help us defend the town and I'll answer any questions you have. Take a post at the top of the wall near the main gate. The hull never lets us down. Now follow me! Be careful on the hull, stranger. Don't fall off! If you do, we might not be able to rescue you in time.
Eyes on the fog. Something's coming.
Bring in the business.
Anglers!
Hold to the back. Sure.
Is that a Pip-Boy?
Avery.
I've heard about those.
Now you see what we're up against. The fog and the creatures it spits out have taken the whole island from my people. For your help when we needed it, you deserve this.
Lost the whole island?
Oh, the fog's been here forever. There are good years when it recedes and the island's almost normal. Then there are times when it spreads all over. people have to cling to any patch of land free of the fog.
For the past, 8 years or so, it's been getting as bad as it's ever been.
Now, Far Harbor's one of the only places left that's safe.
What's the fog?
Where to begin? The fog's radioactive, right? But there are pockets of it, the deep fog, that are hard fallout. And as deadly as that is, that's only part of the problem. Things live in the fog, thrive. You think what attacked the harbor's bad? Oh, there's far worse further inland.
If you manage to survive despite all that, you must be tough.
Ornery, more like. I'm
done cowering behind your damn hull, Avery. Time you let me deal with the real problem. With the right people and my guns, I can end those Children of Adam cultists for good.
The fog's been here forever. The children didn't make it.
Before the Rat Eaters came, the fog was under control. They come, and it all goes wrong. It's time we do something.
No need to burden a stranger with all this nonsense.
What's the deal with the Children of Adam?
They're religious folk. Worship the power of Adam. Which is radiation, I guess. If you want details, you'd have to find and ask them. We used to have a peace with them until a certain hothead menace named Alan Lee.
Now that's enough. That preacher came into the harbor saying that it was Adam's will that we lost our land. That it was Adam's goddamn will that we lost so many friends and family. And that the Adam would wipe this whole place clean of us.
If it were up to me, you'd hang for what you did to that preacher, Alan.
What did he do to the preacher?
Alan pulled a gun on him. He claims the preacher reached for his. We don't have police, or really any law, just custom and popular sentiment. And after everything the preacher said, it was abundantly clear doing anything to Alan would have made matters worse.
Have the children made the fog worse?
Absolutely not. There's not one bit of evidence.
Geiger counters don't lie, Avery. Fog's gotten more lethal year over year. And now the fog's covering the whole island. Only after the children came.
You know as well as I do, that's happened before. Sure, people have theories the children are involved, but no one, and I mean no one, has proof.
Can we get back to business?
Sorry for all that. You're here for Kasumi, right? She headed inland to the Synth Refuge, Acadia. Getting there will be dangerous. You'll need a guide. Old Longfellow. No one knows the fog like him. But word of warning, he's a bit of an acquired taste.
What's Old Longfellow's story?
He's the best hunter on the island. Fearless. Some say crazy. If someone needs to get to Acadia, he's the only one that'll do it. But people around here are known for being stubborn, willful, and other less flattering things. But Longfellow's got a reputation even among us.
What can you tell me about Acadia?
Ask Longfellow. He's the only one that's been there.
Thanks for the info.
Best place to look for Longfellow's at the bar. The last plank. And, please, lend a hand around town if you're able. Even if it's slapped away, people like the Mariner and Cassie and others need help. And let me say something you might not hear again. Thank you.
Protect your loved ones with my fine hands.
Mariner.
The hull took a battering, to be sure. But she wouldn't be standing at all if it weren't for you. They call me the Mariner. Shipwright. Handyman. The only one keeping the harbor afloat. Beside Captain Aker.
Why doesn't anyone help you?
Each harborman is the captain of his own ship. Worked fine for generations on the homesteads. Your land, your rules. But when the island pushed them onto my dock, one by one, the ungrateful bastards expect me to look after my land, even though they're squatting on it like wretches.
The town's lucky you're here.
You blowing smoke up my sails. But there is... I don't suppose you'd be willing to lend a hand. In order to do proper repairs, I need tools. Specialized tools. And they won't be easy to come by. 450 caps if you can, though.
Sign me up. I'll help.
Eagle's Cove Tannery. Tools are certain to be there. Now get.
Guns, guns, and...
Scott.
Need to drown your troubles? Talk to Mitch the last time.
You're that mainlander who just got here. Better watch yourself, because this island sees and hears everything you do. I should know. I watched the island tear down the greatest family that ever set foot in Far Harbour. It's a tale of greed, blood, and vengeance.
What family are you talking about?
I was just about to explain. My family, the Daltons, was the pride of Far Harbor for generations. Even back before the war. It was lumber and fishing that made the Daltons rich. But they got greedy. Took too much from the island. The island's been getting revenge ever since. Killing us off one by one. I'm the last Dalton still standing. Ah, but now our story takes an unexpected turn. A mysterious stranger comes to Far Harbor. Someone strong, someone capable. With the stranger's help, the last living Dalton finally has a chance to avenge her bloodline once and for all.
Let me guess. I'm the mysterious stranger who's gonna help you avenge your family.
Ah, you're a quick one. Good. You'll need your wits about you, because your part in the story is filled with danger. Now, on to the first chapter in our tale of vengeance. That will be the sad story of Freckle-Faced Pete. Petey was my cousin. He was a good lad, never caused trouble. He thought all those freckles brought him luck, but, well, not so much. He was out foraging at the National Park campground when the island sicked some feral ghouls on him. Island's a sneaky bastard when it wants to be. Anyway, he made it back to town, but died from his injuries that night. Of course, those ferals are still out there, waiting to kill the next poor fool who comes along. Damn shame.
Where'd you say these ghouls were?
National Park Campground. It's pretty much straight west of here.
Those ghouls are as good as dead.
Good, good. It's long past time those shamblers paid for what they did to Petey.
Thank you.
the island catch you off guard. By my goodness.
Welcome to the bait shop. If you need any odds and ends, I'm your man.
Let's see what you have.
Of course.
Brooks?
You know, when I'm feeling down, a little commerce always cheers me up.
Let's barter.
Of course. Set you up.
A few times and you think you're some sort of hero? This is our fight. Our island. Not yours.
Hey, buddy. I was just trying to help.
Charity makes you weak. Makes you need it more and more. Until you're starving from the lack of it. What happens next time when you ain't here, huh? For the next. Either us harbormen survive on our own terms, or we take the long walk together. So if you're here to buy some ordnance, do your business. Otherwise, take the first boat out of here, before the children of Adam or worse get you.
Hey.
Is there something you need?
You ain't on. You ain't long for this one. My mind goes.
If I got it.
Shop help you.
That's a trade.
Of course.
Heads up.
Wiped out the feral ghouls at the campground.
The hero of our saga returns triumphant. I bet the island didn't see that coming.
It's only right you get paid for your troubles. Here's 200 caps for you.
So, who else needs to be avenged?
Well, I'm glad you asked. I've been thinking about what's next, and then it came to me. We all love our grandparents, don't we? Kind, gentle, doting, love to spoil you. You'd never want something awful to happen to them. Nobody would. That's why it broke my heart when I lost Grandpa George.
What happened to him?
He had a farm little ways north of here. Lived a peaceful life, working the land, and not causing anyone trouble. The island sent something after him, A huge monster, mean as spit, and with claws to snap steel beams. A fog crawler. Grandpa bravely stood his ground, a shotgun in his hands, holding off that terror while the farmhands fled back here. If you can take out that shell-backed devil, it'll send a message loud and clear that says the Daltons never forget when they've been wronged.
Where can I find this farm?
Follow the coastline to the north.
That fog crawler's gonna pay. For Grandpa George.
That's the spirit.
Alan?
You need some firepower?
Show me what you got.
Don't try anything.
Heads up.
I'll see what I can do.
Grab anything useful.
Can't be done.
Check it out.
How about we try something else? Tinkerer's paradise.
We'll be taking that.
Look alive.
Looking for something?
Hey there.
Hold up! I've been casing those ghouls for weeks, waiting for an opening. And you dive in, and choppy chop, bang bang, and the whole lot of them, dead. You even know what you got right there? A premium set of Pelman's power tools.
What's the big deal about these tools?
Pelman's pumps out more foot-pounds of torque than a Deathclaw and Psycho. And before Polly ran off, he kept those tools shiny. Nothing like them on this island. Period.
I remember commercials for Pelman's tools. Expensive stuff, but top of the line.
What the hell's a commercial? Wait, it don't matter. Oh, Mariner sent you, didn't she? Goddamn Mitch and his big mouth. No matter what she's offering, it's nothing. Serious builders would give an arm for them tools. I'll pay you 2,000 caps right here, right now. Deal?
We have a deal.
Here you go. Just like we promised. Ha! I got myself some Pelmans.
Something?
Is everything all right between us?
I got you as a friend. There's nothing more one old bot could ask for.
That's all for now.
All right.
one day at a time.
Grandpa George can rest in peace. The fog crawler is dead.
Wonderful. That's another chapter successfully concluded. You truly are the heroic Avenger I hoped you were. With that fog crawler gone, we can send some folks up there to get the place ready for you. That's right. The fog is yours. Your own little piece of the island. It'll take work to get it up and running again, but you'll have help. And here's another 200 caps in gratitude for your service to the great Dalton Mage.
Who else needs to be avenged?
I was just about to explain. Now, I don't have to tell you that the bonds of blood and family are strong as any a person can know. But if you ask me, the strongest among them is the bond that exists between two married people. That's why the last part of this tale is the hardest one for me to tell.
You were married.
What happened?
My late husband, Daniel, was the best fisherman this island ever saw. He and his crew had a favorite fishing spot out by Brooks Head Lighthouse. One day, a day I'll never forget, I see Danny's boat pulling up with his crewmen all shouting and carrying on. Turns out some trappers moved into the lighthouse. No doubt because the island told them to. They're all crazier than a bag of mullets. Their leader was having a little target practice. Shot Danny right between the eyes. Killed him, just like that. You go and get that son of a bitch. You make him pay for doing the island's bidding.
How do I get to the Brookshead Lighthouse?
It's southwest of town, not far from the quarry.
I'll make that trapper pay.
All right, then. Remember, trappers may be half crazy from the fog, but they still know how to use a gun.